Welcome to my YouTube channel NCERT Mitra. So in previous video we already discussed a lot of things regarding the weathering and soil formation of their types, soil types and all these things we already discussed. In this video we are going to discuss the main thing of the soil, that is the soil erosion. This is the most one of the, you can say, the burning topic for the farmer of the India. So that's why we are going to discuss the causes of the soil and the soil erosion and types. In this video we are going to discuss the types of the soil erosion, then another video we discuss the their causes and effect we will discuss. Okay, so let's start this video. First thing, if you want to discuss this thing, that the what is soil erosion, so first we have to know the what is soil erosion. Okay, soil erosion, perhaps you can see, soil erosion is defined as a wearing away of the top soil. Means the total topsoil, means that you can say that it would be the 35 to 40 centimeter. This area is known as the topsoil. Okay, so topsoil is the most fertile part of the soil because it contains the most organic and nutrient rich material. Therefore, that farmers want to protect for growing their crops and ranchers, and want to protect for growing grasses for their cattle to graze on. Okay, and there are various ways by which we can say the topsoil can be protected, or you can say that can be lost. Okay, so degradation of the topsoil, or the wearing away, or you can say the degrade of the topsoil, that is known as the soil erosion. There are many causes or the types of the, you can say, the soil erosion. Perhaps you can see types of the soil erosion can be divided. First, that is the soil water erosion. Okay, water erosion means the India is, you can see, the totally prominent with the monsoonal rainfall. So that water erosion, so it is caused by the action of the water, okay, which remove the soil by falling as the drops or the rain drops, as well as by its surface flow actions. Okay, depending upon the form of the lost soil, it may be. So what are the types of the topsoil or the soil erosion? First is the sheet erosion, second is the rill erosion, and third one is the gully erosion. What is sheet erosion? Soil remove the soil like in the thin cover, means one of the thin cover, it is also the blanket, okay, sheet, like a blanket. So when in the large area due to the heavy rainfall, just you can say the over topsoil, few centimeters, 1 and 2 centimeters, just wash out. Okay, and this is called the sheet erosion. Okay, then come to the rill erosion. But when this you can say the sheet erosion is started or sheet erosion occurs, so that time what can the with the full force, so what happened, that this runoff of the water moves repeatedly in the surface of the earth surface, and due to this fact, finger shaped groves like a structure appearing as thin channel, it is considered as the rill erosion. Okay, rill erosion means that it is the finger like erosion, small type of erosion. So sometimes you can see that type of rill erosion can occur in the field, okay, in the football field or any kind of field during the heavy or the moderate rainfall. Then come to the gully erosion. But when these finger types of, you can see the erosion or the drainage, you can see the converges into several rills, so it joined each other, so that time it is called the wider and wider, and this is called the gully erosion. Okay, by this picture, in the next picture I wanted to show actually that the rill erosion, somehow you can see over here the rill erosion is here. Okay, then come to the, you can say that this is the gully erosion, and after that, when gully become larger due to the heavy rainfall, so that time, and continuous rainfall, so that time it is called the, you can say the, we already discussed a lot about this, that is the gully erosion. Okay, so first start from the rill erosion, or the then come to gully, then come to the stream form, and previously that was the sheet erosion. Okay, so this is the main thing. Then come to the wind erosion. Wind also play a vital role for the erosion of the soil. First thing, it is commonly in the dry area, because dry area, perhaps you know, the wind can be move from one area to another area without any obstacle, without any burden, and vegetation cover is very, very less in that area. So wind can move from one area to another area with force. So what happened, wind also carries some of the, you can say, the sediments or silts that work as a blade, and which also work on the surface or the earth surface or the soil. In this process, you can see the wind erosion can be divided into three: saltation, suspension and the surface creep. Perhaps you can see in my diagram, I wanted to show that one of the best, you can see the creeping or the saltation. Saltation, what is? It is the erratic seasons, the low rainfall, drainage is very poor, and high temperature prevail. So what happened? Water evaporates quickly and leaves up the behind the salts only there, okay, salts. So salt accumulation occurs mainly in the lowland and around the surface. So this is mainly, you can see the chlorides, sulfates, carbonates, nitrates of potassium, and magnesium and sodium chloride and the nitrates of calcium. So these are the salts when the dry area is over there, so that can easily up and just you can say the deposited on the soil. So large or the huge amount of the soil, that is also, you can say the that is also hampered for the growth of the plants on the soil. Okay, this thing. Suspension. The wind is throws away the smallest soil particles into air, which moves as fine crust with the winds. By this way, soil are transported to the fairly long distances. Okay, so fairly long distances that can be happen. So suspension, wind throw means all the smallest particles, sediments. Okay, you can see the millimeters or the micromillimeter that can be transported in the desert area from one area to another area. Perhaps you can see. So that's in this diagram. So that is called the suspension. Means that should be floating in the atmosphere. So that. And the wind that transfer from one area to another area, that is called the suspension. Then come to the surface creep. So sometime what happened, this kind of suspension is a heavier particle, so that not easily thrown by the wind, so they can creeping, that is the creep one by one, and that is called the surface creeping. Perhaps in this diagram easily you can see, I make you sure, this diagram creeping, the saltation, then the suspension. Okay, three diagram I have presented, so you can see again and again. Okay, so this thing. Next thing, that is the another thing, perhaps you can see over here, that the next slide, that is the landslide of the slip erosion or the landslide. When there is a very hydraulic pressure or the very heavy rainfall, so that time what happened, the cliffs area or that area can be converted, you can say that landslide occurs in that area, mainly in the mountain area. Perhaps you can see in the left corner of this diagram, so there you can see the landslide. Okay, landslide mainly occur in the mountain area, and when there is a heavy rainfall, so suddenly there is a loss of the gravitational intact between the you can see the soil, so that time they fall from up to down. Okay, perhaps you can see that diagram. Okay, in by, you can see the right side, perhaps you can see. So these are the landslide or the slip erosion. Then come to the erosion, stream bank erosion. What happened? When the river, you can see the overflow during the, you can see the during the flood or the splash or the flash flood. So what happened? The both side of the river or the one side of the river, that also eroded. Okay, so the soil also eroded. So this type of erosion known as the riparian erosion as well. So the stream bank erosion. Okay, number fifth, perhaps you can see, that is the deforestation or the overgrazing. So deforestation and overgrazing also play a vital role for the erosion. Okay, erosion, soil erosion. What happened actually is, there is a vegetation cover on the land, so that time you can see that directly wind cannot work over there. If there is a grass or so that time your runoff also can be decreases. But in the case of there is the land that is which a high, you can say the overgrazing over there, so that time slowly the, you can see the grass is removed from the top soil, and that bare soil is very tends to erode that area. Okay, this thing. So grazing destroy the little cover and enhances the wind and the water erosion. So this is the all about the, you can say the, we already discussed, that is the all about the erosion. Okay, soil erosion or types. Okay, types of the soil erosion we already discussed. Then come to the, you can say the wind erosion. Then come to the landslide, stream bank erosion, deforestation, etc. Okay, this much for today. Okay, thank you for watching this video.